Three treasures, congratulations. Congratulate you in receiving the great Tao. Today is not your wedding day, not the birth of your children, so why are we congratulating you? When we go to Buddha's temple to pray, do people congratulate you after the prayer ceremony? No. So why today is so special that after praying and obtaining the great Tao that today so many people congratulate you? Because today is the auspicious day that you obtained the great Tao. So what is so special about great Tao? Let me explain to you in detail. Tao is the creator of universe, the source of everything that exists, the four seasons, the day and night movement, the movement of planets and time. It is also the unifying force or principle that gives rise to all natural laws. Tao is also the path / direction of spiritual cultivation, where we can eventually become saints or Buddha. Every ancient saint, Buddhas obtained the Tao in the pastime, so they were able to surpass the limits or boundary of birth and death and exist forever. Now what you obtain today is just the same as what they did. Tao is our true self. It is the center of all thoughts, feelings, emotions and control all bodily existence. Tao is the spirit of a human being. What is the difference between a living person and a dead person? A dead person has eyes, nose, ears, hands and legs, but why is that a living person can move and talk but a dead person cannot? This is because of the existence of Tao/spirit in the person. So it is said that a vehicle or a car, bus or a train, cannot move without the driver, which is similar to the spirit of a body that controls its mind, actions and speech. Tao/spirit is the source of everything. This Tao exists in everyone and everyone has Tao. But because we are too obsessed in this material world that we forgot our true self. So today, through this Tao transmitting ceremony, we help you discover back our true self. Today you have obtained the Tao because of three reasons. 1. You have the affinity with Buddha. 2. You had done virtues and so did your ancestors. 3. You had cultivated in a religion in your previous lives. These three reasons enable you to have the affinity to obtain Tao, otherwise you would never obtain it. In the ancient days, one who intended to receive Tao had to abandon all the worldly possessions and enjoyments. If he was a king, he had to abandon his kingdom. If he was a high official, he had to give up his high position, leave his family and went to remote mountains to seek for the great teacher who could point him the way to transmit him the Tao. After he had experienced all sufferings and had changed his heart into a holy heart, as well as his perfect conduct, besides he had done many good deeds to people, then with his full sincerity he finally moved the heart of God, thus God sent Buddha to point out the way to transmit the Tao to him. Under such condition, the successor was hard to find. In that period, I was secretly transmitted from one patriarch to the next patriarch. But today we are not required to go to the remote mountains, and we have yet to cultivate ourselves either. So why can we receive Tao so easily now? This is because the time is different. Today human beings facing calamities, the doomsday is coming, it will destroy all human beings. The moral values in people have deteriorated, so we can see a lot of calamities such as flooding, volcano eruptions, tsunami, 911 terrorists attacks, floods, diseases. What causes the calamities? The reason is that in this modern age, most of the people in the world have lost their conscience. Note, human heart is okay. But we usually say the conscience emerged from the spirit. The mindfulness of the right and wrong is due to the conscience as awareness. Where the liberal is to benefit themselves, they do all evils. So it causes the great disaster which hasn't been ever before and will not occur anymore afterward. We call it the last calamity. In this calamity, not only the whole human being, the whole world, but also the immortal sky and the ghosts in the hell will be destroyed and vanished. However, God, our Supreme Mother, note, in the Philippines, we say God the Creator, or the Supreme Being. We rarely use the feminine gender to represent God. But in the Tao Seminar in Chinese, we are taught to use the feminine gender to represent God. Right parenthesis, He bestows our soul as merciful and compassionate. She cannot bear all good and bad being destroyed altogether. In order to save the good people, the merciful Buddhas bestowed us with the great Tao. So she descends the Tao and sends the great teacher Buddha Sikhu and Bodhisattva Yumi to come to the world to a rescue. The three kinds of creatures, they are the immortal sky, the human being in the world, and the ghost in the hell altogether return to heaven. Our Master Shijun and Shibu, under the command of God, transmit the true Tao to the three kinds of creature. Their duty is to manage the so-called the last salvation. This salvation is without a word. This transmission is out of preaching. It directly points out the original nature of mankind to make people realize their original nature, then come to enlightenment. When the last calamity comes, nothing can save mankind, except the only way that is Tao, which is descended by God. That's why the Tao is widely propagated in nowadays to save the good man. So after we have obtained Tao, we have to seriously cultivate ourselves. Then automatically we shall be free from danger, escape from the calamity, transcend from reincarnation and become saints or Buddhas as well. Ladies and gentlemen, you have received the great almighty Tao today. However, what did you get actually get? During the Tao transmitting ceremony just now, the Master has transmitted us with three treasures. These three treasures are your three important proofs to enter heaven. 1. Heavenly portal, mysterious door. 2. Heavenly password, holy sutra. 3. Heavenly hand sign, hand seal. 1. Heavenly portal, mysterious door. The portal is not well understood by many people, even though we see clues about its importance all the time. For instance, when you close your eyes, clasp your hands together and lower your head to pray, you automatically focus your mind at the portal. This action is completely natural, and something we all do without a thought. Also, consider what happens when you frown because something troubles you, or glare at someone out of anger. In those situations, your pore is literally clenched tightly shut. The mental pressure from anxiety or anger puts tremendous weight on the spiritual doorway, cutting off your soul from everything around you. This is why we feel so disconnected from others when we are angry or anxious. Similarly, when we see someone in an extremely negative frame of mind, we may find it difficult to get through to him or her. These expressions make perfect sense once you understand the central role of the mystic portal. The portal is also called the gate/door in which the spirit enters and exits a physical body. The mysterious door is the main door. It is located just at the center part of our head, not to the left, right, above or below. Just now I asked, what is the difference between a dead and a living person? Both have eyes, ears, mouth, hands and legs, but one is not moving. Why? Because the spirit has left. When spirit joins a body, a person is said to be living. When separated, death occurs. So we need the enlightening master to open this gate, as at the moment of death, our spirit would know the right path to go and return to heaven. If the eyes are the windows to the soul, then the portal is the doorway. Confucius said, who else can get out of the house without crossing the door? But why do people not follow this way? We enter the house from the main door, and similarly we exit the house through the main door, same for our soul. Many people do not know the right way/door to the soul, and even for some when they know the right way, they do not cultivate themselves and let greed/obsession/hatred to block/lock the right door, and thus the soul could not exit through the main door. Just like a house when it is on fire and the main door is locked, people will escape by the side doors to save their lives. Likewise, when death occurs and our mysterious door is not open, our spirit will exit through the side doors. We are born as viviparous animals, such as horses, cows, dogs. As reborn as oviparous, such as birds, ducks. Mouth reborn as animals as water, such as fishes, lobster. Nose reborn as insect, such as flies, moth, bees, mosquitoes. Liver reborn as plain, poor people. Vertex reborn as wealthy and powerful people. These mentioned above are the ways of reincarnation, cannot be freed from the sufferings of birth and death. Today the enlightening master opens our right door. This is the way to heaven. We don't get out by the side doors anymore. We shall not fall into the sufferings of reincarnation, but we have to cultivate ourselves, because we cannot return to heaven if we are still full of sin. 2. Heavenly Password, Holy Sutra, the second treasure XXXXX. Is the words that Master asked us to repeat after him. This is the Holy Sutra. This holy sutra cannot be found in books or sutras. We have to memorize it by heart. It consists of sounds without words, so it is also known as the Wordless Sutra. It is a mantra or chant of power that resonates or vibrates or echoes that are ever beyond the sound waves and writings of the material world. Many people are not aware of the true sutra, but it's not a new idea. The concept goes back at least 2,500 years. The Tao Te Ching tells us that the Tao that can be spoken is not the eternal Tao. Similarly, when the Sakyamuni Buddha wanted to pass on his true teachings, he chose to do so without words. He specifically told his disciples that his transmission of the spiritual essence would be totally apart from written scripture. Instead, it would pass directly from one heart to another. First word represents the heavenly world, Ruji. It is non-moving, it is the quintessential state of Tao. Second word represents the Qi world, Taiji. It is Tao in motion. It gives rise to yin and yang. Third word represents the earthly world, Wanji. This is the world we are living where all existence our Shang can be seen, heard or felt. They are transient and liable to change. The state of the earthly world is characterized by temporality and deterioration, including human, animals and vegetations. Last two words represent the Maitreya Buddha in Sanskrit meaning mercy and compassion. Mercy refrains from killing and compassion eradicates sufferings. We are to follow Maitreya Buddha as role modeling cultivation. His smiley face and big belly show his great capacity in embracing all good and bad things. Tolerance and acceptance. This treasure can be used when we are in a very dangerous situation. You mention the sutra in your mouth without a voice, and hold on the holy hand sign, immediately you will be saved by Buddha and get out of the dangerous state. If we cultivate ourselves sincerely, certainly, we will be under the refuge of Buddha. We can use the true sutra when we encounter challenges in life. Perhaps you see an obstacle that seems too difficult to overcome. Perhaps there is a temptation that seems too strong to resist. Perhaps you find yourself in a confrontational situation and it is becoming harder and harder to remain polite. Whenever you feel you need extra assistance from a source outside of yourself, repeat the sutra or chant silently to yourself. A wellspring of strength will emerge for you. 3. Heavenly hand sign seal. The hand sign is the proof that we have already obtained Tao. It symbolizes the agreement we made with God. It also reminds us of nurturing love. It is a gesture where one hand holds the other, which represents the tender loving care that you feel when you hold an infant in your arms. This will remind us of the child within us. A childlike state that sees wonder in everything, that does not judge or criticize and contains only pure and innocent mind. The hand seal reminds us how precious this inner child is, and how we can rediscover our original nature through doubt cultivation. On another level, the hand seal suggests the love between ourselves and those who are close to us, for it is this love that gives our lives meaning and purpose. As we hold the hand seal close to the chest, we can feel its power. It is the love that has, over the span of human history, inspired the creation of art and beautiful music. It is the power that motivates us to achieve the impossible or even sacrifice ourselves. To us, there is nothing more vital to life. Ultimately, the meaning of this treasure extends beyond us, our family, friends and loved ones. The highest level of the hand seal is the pure essence of universal love. When we expand our awareness outward, we begin to realize that everyone is the energy of love solidified into human form. We learn to see the divine or heavenly in all people, no matter who they are. When this treasure extends beyond human beings, we begin to realize that all living things are part of the same energy too. The 10,000 things, including ourselves, are all musical notes in a great cosmic symphony. We begin to realize that the word universe means literally one verse of this grand composition. When we use the hand seal, we tune into this universal, musical essence. It resonates in the core of our being. In the presence of this great power, we feel grateful and humble. It is a power that nurtures and protects us, just as we nurture and protect those we love. In our daily lives, it can be easy for us to get disconnected from the essence of love. The material world, with its temptations and pressures, can warp and twist our emotions into envy, jealousy, and even hatred. These feelings manifest themselves as annoyances, irritations, anger, and even heated outbursts. The hand seal reconnects us. When we feel as if we are about to lose temper, when we sense tension and frustration mounting, this treasure will bring us back to where we really want to be. It points us to our original nature, and reminds us that we are, in our innermost selves, beings of light and divine manifestations or appearance of love. This is the third treasure. Three treasures, congratulations. Congratulate you in receiving the great Tao. Today is not your wedding day, not the birth of your children, so why are we congratulating you? When we go to Buddha's temple to pray, do people congratulate you after the prayer ceremony? No. So why today is so special that after praying and obtaining the great Tao that today so many people congratulate you? Because today is the auspicious day that you obtained the great Tao. So what is so special about great Tao? Let me explain to you in detail. Tao is the creator of universe, the source of everything that exists, the four seasons, the day and night movement, the movement of planets and time. It is also the unifying force or a principle that gives rise to all natural laws. Tao is also the path / direction of spiritual cultivation, where we can eventually become saints or Buddha. Every ancient saint, Buddhas obtained the Tao in the pastime, so they were able to surpass the limits or the boundary of birth and death and exist forever. Now what you obtain today is just the same as what they did. Tao is our true self. It is the center of all thoughts, feelings, emotions and control all bodily existence. Tao is the spirit of a human being. What is the difference between a living person and a dead person? A dead person has eyes, nose, ears, hands and legs, but why is that a living person can move and talk but a dead person cannot? This is because of the existence of Tao/spirit in the person. So it is said that a vehicle or a car, bus or a train, cannot move without the driver, which is similar to the spirit of a body that controls its mind, actions and speech. Tao/spirit is the source of everything. This Tao exists in everyone and everyone has Tao. But because we are too obsessed in this material world that we forgot our true self. So today, through this Tao transmitting ceremony, we help you discover back our true self. Today you have obtained the Tao because of three reasons. 1. You have the affinity with Buddha. 2. You had done virtues and so did your ancestors. 3. You had cultivated a religion in your previous lives. These three reasons enable you to have the affinity to obtain Tao, otherwise you would never obtain it. In the ancient days, one who intended to receive Tao had to abandon all the worldly possessions and enjoyments. If he was a king, he had to abandon his kingdom. If he was a high official, he had to give up his high position, leave his family and went to remote mountains to seek for the great teacher who could point him a way to transmit him the Tao. After he had experienced all sufferings and had changed his heart into a holy heart, as well as his perfect conduct, besides he had done many good deeds to people, then with his full sincerity he finally moved the heart of God. Thus God sent Buddha to point out the way to transmit the Tao to him. Under such condition, the successor is hard to find. In that period Tao was secretly transmitted from one patriarch to the next patriarch. But today we are not required to go to the remote mountains and we have yet to cultivate ourselves either. So why can we receive Tao so easily now? This is because the time is different. Today human beings facing calamities, the doomsday is coming, it will destroy all human beings. The moral values in people have deteriorated so we can see a lot of calamities such as flooding, volcano eruptions, tsunami, 911 terrorist attacks, floods, diseases. What causes the calamities? The reason is that in this modern age, most of the people in the world have lost their conscience. Note, human heart is okay. but we usually say the conscience emerged from the spirit. The mindfulness of the right and wrong is due to the conscience as awareness. Where the liberal is to benefit themselves, they do all evils. So it causes the great disaster which hasn't been ever before and will not occur anymore afterward. We call it the last calamity. In this calamity, not only the whole human being, the whole world, but also the immortal sky and the ghosts in the hell will be destroyed and vanished. However, God our Supreme Mother, note, in the Philippines, we say God the Creator, or the Supreme Being. We rarely use the feminine gender to represent God. But in the Dao Seminar in Chinese we are taught to use the feminine gender to represent God. Right parenthesis, He bestows our soul is merciful and compassionate. She cannot bear all good and bad being destroyed altogether. In order to save the good people, the merciful Buddha's bestowed us with the great Dao. So she descends the Dao and sends the great teacher Buddha Sikhu and Bodhisattva Yumi to come to the world to rescue. The three kinds of creatures, they are the immortal sky, the human being in the world, and the ghost in the hell altogether return to heaven. Our master Shijun and Shimu under the command of God transmit the true Dao to the three kinds of creature. Their duty is to manage the so-called the last salvation. This salvation is without a word, this transmission is out of preaching, it directly points out the original nature of mankind to make people realize their original nature then come to enlightenment. When the last calamity comes, nothing can save mankind, except the only way that is Dao which is descended by God. That's why the Dao is widely propagated in nowadays to save the good man. So after we have obtained Dao we have to seriously cultivate ourselves, then automatically we shall be free from danger, escape from the calamity, transcend from reincarnation and become saints or Buddhas as well. Ladies and gentlemen, you have received the great almighty Dao today. However, what did you get actually get? During the Dao transmitting ceremony just now, the Master has transmitted us with three treasures. These three treasures are your three important proofs to enter heaven. 1. Heavenly portal mysterious door. 2. Heavenly password holy sutra. 3. Heavenly hand sign hand seal. 1. Heavenly portal, mysterious door. The portal is not well understood by many people, even though we see clues about its importance all the time. For instance, when you close your eyes, clasp your hands together and lower your head to pray, you automatically focus your mind at the portal. This action is completely natural, and something we all do without a thought. Also, consider what happens when you frown because something troubles you, or glare at someone out of anger. In those situations, your portal is literally clenched tightly shut. The mental pressure from anxiety or anger puts tremendous weight on the spiritual doorway, cutting off your soul from everything around you. This is why we feel so disconnected from others when we are angry or anxious. Similarly, when we see someone in an extremely negative frame of mind, we may find it difficult to get through to him or her. These expressions make perfect sense once you understand the central role of the mystic portal. The port is also called the gate slash door in which the spirit enters and exits a physical body. The mysterious door is the main door. It is located just at the center part of our head, not to the left, right, above or below. Just now I asked, what is the difference between a dead and a living person? Both have eyes, ears, mouth, hands and legs, but one is not moving. Why? 'Cause the spirit has left. When spirit joins a body, a person is said to be living. When separated, death occurs. So we need the enlightening master to open this gate, as at the moment of death, our spirit would know the right path to go and return to heaven. If the eyes are the windows to the soul, then the portal is the doorway. Confucius said, who else can get out of the house without crossing the door? But why do people not follow this way? We enter the house from the main door, and similarly we exit the house through the main door. Same for our soul. Many people do not know the right way slash door to the soul, and even for some when they know the right way, they do not cultivate themselves and let greed slash obsession slash hatred to block slash lock the right door, and thus the soul could not exit through the main door. Just like a house when it is on fire and the main door is locked, people will escape by the side doors to save their lives. Likewise, when death occurs and our mysterious door is not open, our spirit will exit through the side doors. Here we begin as viviparous animals, such as horses, cows, dogs. As we begin as oviparous, such as birds, ducks. Mouth we begin as animals as water, such as fishes, lobster. Nose reborn as insect, such as flies, moth, bees, mosquitoes. Liver reborn as plain, poor people. Vertex reborn as wealthy and powerful people. These mentioned above are the ways of reincarnation, cannot be freed from the sufferings of birth and death. Today the enlightening master opens our right door. This is the way to heaven. We don't get out by the side doors anymore. We shall not fall into the sufferings of reincarnation, but we have to cultivate ourselves, because we cannot return to heaven if we are still full of sin. 2. Heavenly Password, Holy Sutra, the second treasure XXXXX, is the words that Master asked us to repeat after him. This is the Holy Sutra. This Holy Sutra cannot be found in books or sutras. We have to memorize it by heart. It consists of sounds without words. So it is also known as the Wordless Sutra. It is a mantra or chant of power that resonates or vibrates or echoes that arrive beyond the sound waves and writings of the material world. Many people are not aware of the true sutra, but it's not a new idea. The concept goes back at least 2,500 years. The Tao Te Ching tells us that the Tao that can be spoken is not the eternal Tao. Similarly, when the Sakyamuni Buddha wanted to pass on his true teachings, he chose to do so without words. He specifically told his disciples that his transmission of the spiritual essence would be totally apart from written scripture. Instead, it would pass directly from one heart to another. First word represents the heavenly world, Ruji. It is non-moving, it is the quintessential state of Tao. Second word represents the Qi world, Taiji. It is Tao in motion. It gives rise to a yin and yang. Third word represents the earthly world, Wanji. This is the world we are living where all existence or Shang can be seen, heard or felt. They are transient and liable to change. The state of earthly world is characterized by temporality and deterioration, including human, animals and vegetations. Last two words represent the Maitreya Buddha in Sanskrit meaning mercy and compassion. Mercy refrains from killing and compassion eradicates sufferings. We are to follow Maitreya Buddha as role modeling cultivation. His smiley face and big goal show his great capacity in embracing all good and bad things, tolerance and acceptance. This treasure can be used when we are in a very dangerous situation. You mention the sutra in your mouth without a voice, and hold on the holy hand sign. Immediately you will be saved by Buddha and get out of the dangerous state. If we cultivate ourselves sincerely, certainly, we will be under the refuge of Buddha. We can use the true sutra when we encounter challenges in life. Perhaps you see an obstacle that seems too difficult to overcome. Perhaps there is a temptation that seems too strong to resist. Perhaps you find yourself in a confrontational situation and it is becoming harder and harder to remain polite. Whenever you feel you need extra assistance from a source outside of yourself, repeat the sutra or chant silently to yourself. A wellspring of strength will emerge for you. 3. Heavenly hand sign seal. The hand sign is the proof that we have already obtained Tao. It symbolizes the agreement we made with God. It also reminds us of nurturing love. It is a gesture where one hand holds the other, which represents the tender loving care that you feel when you hold an infant in your arms. This will remind us of the child within us. A childlike state that sees wonder in everything, that does not judge or criticize and contains only pure and innocent mind. The hand seal reminds us how precious this inner child is, and how we can rediscover our original nature through Tao cultivation. On another level, the hand seal suggests the love between ourselves and those who are close to us, for it is this love that gives our lives meaning and purpose. As we hold the hand seal close to the chest, we can feel its power. It is the love that has, over the span of human history, inspired the creation of art and beautiful music. It is the power that motivates us to achieve the impossible or even sacrifice ourselves. To us, there is nothing more vital to a life. Ultimately, the meaning of this treasure extends beyond us, our family, friends and loved ones. The highest level of the hand seal is the pure essence of universal love. When we expand our awareness outward, we begin to realize that everyone is the energy of love solidified into human form. We learn to see the divine or heavenly in all people, no matter who they are. When this treasure extends beyond human beings, we begin to realize that all living things are part of the same energy too. The 10,000 things, including ourselves, are all musical notes in a great cosmic symphony. We begin to realize that the word universe means literally one verse of this grand composition. When we use the hand seal, we tune into this universal, musical essence. It resonates in the core of our being. In the presence of this great power, we feel grateful and humble. It is a power that nurtures and protects us, just as we nurture and protect those we love. In our daily lives, it can be easy for us to get disconnected from the essence of love. The material world, with its temptations and pressures, can warp and twist our emotions into envy, jealousy, and even hatred. These feelings manifest themselves as annoyances, irritations, anger, and even heated outbursts. The hand seal reconnects us. When we feel as if we are about to lose temper, when we sense tension and frustration mounting, this treasure will bring us back to where we really want to be. It points us to our original nature, and reminds us that we are, in our innermost selves, beings of light and divine manifestations or appearance of love. This is the third treasure. Three treasures, congratulations. Congratulate you in receiving the great Tao. Today is not your wedding day, not the birth of your children, so why are we congratulating you? When we go to Buddha's temple to pray, do people congratulate you after the prayer ceremony? No. So why today is so special that after praying and obtaining the great Tao that today so many people congratulate you? Because today is the auspicious day that you obtained the great Tao. So what is so special about great Tao? Let me explain to you in detail. Tao is the creator of universe, the source of everything that exists, the four seasons, the day and night movement, the movement of planets and time. It is also the unifying force or principle that gives rise to all natural laws. Tao is also the path / direction of spiritual cultivation, where we can eventually become saints or a Buddha. Every ancient saint, Buddhas obtained the Tao in the pastime, so they were able to surpass the limits or a boundary of birth and death and exist forever. Now what you obtain today is just the same as what they did. Tao is our true self. It is the center of all thoughts, feelings, emotions and control all bodily existence. Tao is the spirit of a human being. What is the difference between a living person and a dead person? A dead person has eyes, nose, ears, hands and legs, but why is that a living person can move and talk but a dead person cannot? This is because of the existence of Tao/spirit in the person. So it is said that a vehicle or a car, bus or a train, cannot move without the driver, which is similar to the spirit of a body that controls its mind, actions and speech. Tao/spirit is the source of everything. This Tao exists in everyone and everyone has Tao. But because we are too obsessed in this material world that we forgot our true self. So today, through this Tao transmitting ceremony, we help you discover back our true self. Today you have obtained the Tao because of three reasons. 1. You have the affinity with Buddha. 2. You had done virtues and so did your ancestors. 3. You had cultivated in a religion in your previous lives. These three reasons enable you to have the affinity to obtain Tao, otherwise you would never obtain it. In the ancient days, one who intended to receive Tao had to abandon all the worldly possessions and enjoyments. If he was a king, he had to abandon his kingdom. If he was a high official, he had to give up his high position, leave his family and went to remote mountains to seek for the great teacher who could point him a way to transmit him the Tao. After he had experienced all sufferings and had changed his heart into a holy heart, as well as his perfect conduct, besides he had done many good deeds to people, then with his full sincerity he finally moved the heart of God. Thus God sent Buddha to point out the way to transmit the Tao to him. Under such condition, the successor was hard to find. In that period Tao was secretly transmitted from one patriarch to the next patriarch. But today we are not required to go to the remote mountains and we have yet to cultivate ourselves either. So why can we receive Tao so easily now? This is because the time is different. Today human beings facing calamities, the doomsday is coming, it will destroy all human beings. The moral values in people have deteriorated so we can see a lot of calamities such as flooding, volcano eruptions, tsunami, 911 terrorist attacks, floods, diseases. What causes the calamities? The reason is that in this modern age, most of the people in the world have lost their conscience. Note, human heart is okay. But we usually say the conscience emerged from the spirit. The mindfulness of the right and wrong is due to the conscience as awareness where it enables to benefit themselves. They do all evils, so it causes the great disaster which hasn't been ever before and will not occur anymore afterward. We call it the last calamity. In this calamity, not only the whole human being, the whole world, but also the immortal sky and the ghosts in the hell will be destroyed and vanished. However, God our Supreme Mother, note, in the Philippines, we say God the Creator, or the Supreme Being. We rarely use the feminine gender to represent God. But in the Tao seminar in Chinese, we are taught to use the feminine gender to represent God. Right parenthesis, He bestows our soul is merciful and compassionate. She cannot bear all good and bad being destroyed altogether. In order to save the good people, the merciful Buddhas bestowed us with the great Tao. So she descends the Tao and sends the great teacher Buddha Sikun and Bodhisattva Yumi to come to the world to a rescue. The three kinds of creatures, they are the immortal sky, the human being in the world, and the ghost in the hell, all together return to heaven. Our master Shijun and Shimu, under the command of God, transmit the true Tao to the three kinds of creature. Their duty is to manage the so-called the last salvation. This salvation is without a word, this transmission is out of preaching. It directly points out the original nature of mankind to make people realize their original nature, then come to enlightenment. When the last calamity comes, nothing can save mankind, except the only way, that is Tao, which is descended by God. That's why the Tao is widely propagated in nowadays to save the good man. So after we have obtained Tao, we have to seriously cultivate ourselves. Then automatically we shall be free from danger, escape from the calamity, transcend from reincarnation and become saints or Buddhas as well. Ladies and gentlemen, you have received the great almighty Tao today. However, what did you get actually get? During the Tao transmitting ceremony just now, the Master has transmitted us with three treasures. These three treasures are your three important proofs to enter heaven. 1. Heavenly portal, mysterious door. 2. Heavenly password, holy sutra. 3. Heavenly hand sign, hand seal. 1. Heavenly portal, mysterious door. The portal is not well understood by many people, even though we see clues about its importance all the time. For instance, when you close your eyes, clasp your hands together and lower your head to pray, you automatically focus your mind at the portal. This action is completely natural, and something we all do without a thought. Also, consider what happens when you frown because something troubles you, or glare at someone out of anger. In those situations, your portal is literally clenched tightly shut. The mental pressure from anxiety or anger puts tremendous weight on the spiritual doorway, cutting off your soul from everything around you. This is why we feel so disconnected from others when we are angry or anxious. Similarly, when we see someone in an extremely negative frame of mind, we may find it difficult to get through to him or her. These expressions make perfect sense once you understand the central role of the mystic portal. The portal is also called the gate/door in which the spirit enters and exits a physical body. The mysterious door is the main door. It is located just at the center part of our head, not to the left, right, above or below. Just now I asked, what is the difference between a dead and a living person? Both have eyes, ears, mouth, hands and legs, but one is not moving. Why? Because the spirit has left. When spirit joins a body, a person is said to be living. When separated, death occurs. So we need the enlightening master to open this gate, as at the moment of death, our spirit would know the right path to go and return to heaven. If the eyes are the windows to the soul, then the portal is the doorway. Confucius said, who else can get out of the house without crossing the door? But why do people not follow this way? We enter the house from the main door and similarly we exit the house through the main door, same for our soul. Many people do not know the right way/door to the soul, and even for someone they know the right way, they do not cultivate themselves and let greed/obsession/hatred to block/lock the right door, and thus the soul could not exit through the main door. Just like a house when it is on fire and the main door is locked, people will escape by the side doors to save their lives. Likewise, when death occurs and our mysterious door is not open, our spirit will exit through the side doors. We are reborn as viviparous animals, such as horses, cows, dogs. As reborn as oviparous, such as birds, ducks. Mouth reborn as animals as water, such as fishes, lobster. Nose reborn as insect, such as flies, moth, bees, mosquitoes. Navel reborn as plain, poor people. Vertex reborn as wealthy and powerful people. These mentioned above are the ways of reincarnation, cannot free from the sufferings of birth and death. Today the Enlightening Master opens our right door. This is the way to heaven. We don't get out by the side doors anymore. We shall not fall into the sufferings of reincarnation, but we have to cultivate ourselves, because we are not turned to heaven if we are still full of sin. 2. Heavenly Password Holy Sutra. The second treasure XXXXX is the words that Master asked us to repeat after him. This is the Holy Sutra. This Holy Sutra cannot be found in books or sutras. We have to memorize it by heart. It consists of sounds without words, so it is also known as the Wordless Sutra. It is a mantra or chant of power that resonates or vibrates or echoes that level beyond the sound waves and writings of the material world. Many people are not aware of the true sutra, but it's not a new idea. The concept goes back at least 2,500 years. The Tao Te Ching tells us that the Tao that can be spoken is not the eternal Tao. Similarly, when the Sakyamuni Buddha wanted to pass on his true teachings, he chose to do so without words. He specifically told his disciples that his transmission of the spiritual essence would be totally apart from written scripture. Instead, it would pass directly from one heart to another. First word represents the heavenly world, Wuji. It is non-moving, it is the quintessential state of Tao. Second word represents the Qi world, Taiji. It is Tao in motion. It gives rise to a yin and yang. Third word represents the earthly world, Wanji. This is the world we are living where all existence or shang can be seen, heard or felt. They are transient and liable to change. The state of earthly world is characterized by temporality and deterioration. including human, animals and vegetations. Last two words represent the Maitreya Buddha in Sanskrit, meaning mercy and compassion. Mercy refrains from killing and compassion eradicates sufferings. We are to follow Maitreya Buddha as role modeling cultivation. His smiley face and big belly show his great capacity in embracing all good and bad things. Tolerance and acceptance. This treasure can be used when we are in a very dangerous situation. You mention the sutra in your mouth without a voice, and hold on the holy hand sign. Immediately you will be saved by Buddha and get out of the dangerous state. If we cultivate ourselves sincerely, certainly, we will be under the refuge of Buddha. We can use the true sutra when we encounter challenges in life. Perhaps you see an obstacle that seems too difficult to overcome. Perhaps there is a temptation that seems too strong to resist. Perhaps you find yourself in a confrontational situation and it is becoming harder and harder to remain polite. Whenever you feel you need extra assistance from a source outside of yourself, repeat the sutra or chant silently to yourself. A wellspring of strength will emerge for you. 3. Heavenly hand sign seal. The hand sign is the proof that we have already obtained Tao. It symbolizes the agreement we made with God. It also reminds us of nurturing love. It is a gesture where one hand holds the other, which represents the tender loving care that you feel when you hold an infant in your arms. This will remind us of the child within us. A childlike state that sees wonder in everything, that does not judge or criticize and contains only pure and innocent mind. The hand seal reminds us how precious this inner child is, and how we can rediscover our original nature through doubt cultivation. On another level, the hand seal suggests the love between ourselves and those who are close to us, for it is this love that gives our lives meaning and purpose. As we hold the hand seal close to the chest, we can feel its power. It is the love that has, over the span of human history, inspired the creation of art and beautiful music. It is the power that motivates us to achieve the impossible or even sacrifice ourselves. To us, there is nothing more vital to a life. Ultimately, the meaning of this treasure extends beyond us, our family, friends and loved ones. The highest level of the hand seal is the pure essence of universal love. When we expand our awareness outward, we begin to realize that everyone is the energy of love solidified into human form. We learn to see the divine or heavenly in all people, no matter who they are. When this treasure extends beyond human beings, we begin to realize that all living things are part of the same energy too. The 10,000 things, including ourselves, are all musical notes in a great cosmic symphony. We begin to realize that the word universe means literally one verse of this grand composition. When we use the hand seal, we tune into this universal, musical essence. It resonates in the core of our being. In the presence of this great power, we feel grateful and humble. It is a power that nurtures and protects us, just as we nurture and protect those we love. In our daily lives, it can be easy for us to get disconnected from the essence of love. The material world, with its temptations and pressures, can warp and twist our emotions into envy, jealousy, and even hatred. These feelings manifest themselves as annoyances, irritations, anger, and even heated outbursts. The hand seal reconnects us. When we feel as if we are about to lose temper, when we sense tension and frustration mounting, this treasure will bring us back to where we really want to be. It points us to our original nature, and reminds us that we are, in our innermost selves, beings of light and divine manifestations or appearance of love. This is the third treasure. Three treasures. Congratulations. Congratulate you in receiving the great Tao. Today is not your wedding day, not the birth of your children, so why are we congratulating you? When we go to Buddha's temple to pray, do people congratulate you after the prayer ceremony? No. So why today is so special that after praying and obtaining the great Tao that today so many people congratulate you? Because today is the auspicious day that you obtained the great Tao. So what is so special about great Tao? Let me explain to you in detail. Tao is the creator of universe, the source of everything that exists, the four seasons, the day and night movement, the movement of planets and time. It is also the unifying force or a principle that gives rise to all natural laws. Tao is also the path / direction of spiritual cultivation, where we can eventually become saints or a Buddha. Every ancient saint, Buddhas obtained the Tao in the pastime, so they were able to surpass the limits or the boundary of birth and death and exist forever. Now what you obtain today is just the same as what they did. Tao is our true self. It is the center of all thoughts, feelings, emotions and control all bodily existence. Tao is the spirit of a human being. What is the difference between a living person and a dead person? A dead person has eyes, nose, ears, hands and legs, but why is that a living person can move and talk but a dead person cannot? This is because of the existence of Tao/spirit in the person. So it is said that a vehicle or a car, bus or a train, cannot move without the driver, which is similar to the spirit of a body that controls its mind, actions and speech. Tao/spirit is the source of everything. This Tao exists in everyone and everyone has Tao. But because we are too obsessed in this material world that we forgot our true self. So today, through this Tao transmitting ceremony, we help you discover back our true self. Today you have obtained the Tao because of three reasons. 1. You had the affinity with Buddha, too. You had done virtues and so did your ancestors. 3. You had cultivated a religion in your previous lives. These 3 reasons enable you to have the affinity to obtain Tao, otherwise you would never obtain it. In the ancient days, one who intended to receive Tao had to abandon all the worldly possessions and enjoyments. If he was a king, he had to abandon his kingdom. If he was a high official, he had to give up his high position, leave his family and went to remote mountains to seek for the great teacher who could point him away to
32相82好舍太子为出家学道勤行精进觉悟 一切种智而谓之佛亦曰佛陀亦曰浮屠皆胡言也华言 一知为净觉其所说云人生虽有生死之至于精神则恒不 灭此生之前则经无量生以积而修习精神清净则成佛 到天地之外四维上下更有天地亦无终极然皆有成有 拜一乘一拜谓之一劫自此天地以前则有无量劫以美 劫必有诸佛得道出世教化其数不同经此劫中有千佛自出至于释迦以七佛以其次有弥勒出世必经三会演说法藏开度众生由其道者有四等之果亦曰须陀洹耳曰斯陀含三曰阿那含四曰阿罗汉至罗汉者则出入生死 去领显而不为阿罗汉以上至菩萨者身见佛性矣至成道美佛灭度以法相传有正相末三等纯出之年岁远近一个不同末法以后众生愚钝无复佛教而也行转恶年受见短经数百千载艰乃至朝生系死然后有大 水大火大风之灾一切除去之而更立生人又归淳朴谓之小劫每一小劫则一佛出世出天竺中多诸外道病是水火毒而善诸变幻释迦 PG794之苦行也是诸邪道病来鸟恼以乱其心而不能得及佛 道成境皆摧伏并为弟子弟子南曰桑门一言习心儿总曰僧一言行起女曰比丘尼皆替洛须法事类辞家乡与何居至心修进行起以自资而防心摄行僧至二百五十见尼五百戒俗人性平佛法者南曰优婆塞女曰优婆夷 皆去杀道营妄言饮酒是为五戒释迦在世教化四十九年乃至天人鬼病来听法弟子得道以百千万亿数然后于居师那城梭罗双树兼以二月十五日入班涅盘涅盘议曰尼还一言灭度一言长乐我尽出释迦说法以人之信时 根业各刹故有大臣小臣之说至是谢氏弟子大家业与阿难等五百人追供撰述坠以文字记载为十二部后数百年有罗汉菩萨相继着论赞明其亦然佛所说我灭度后证法五百年相法一千年末法三千年其亦如此 推寻典籍自汉以上中国未传获云久以流不遭情之是所以因灭其后张骞时西域盖文有浮屠之教哀帝时博士弟子秦景十一存口授浮屠经中图文之谓之信也后汉明帝夜梦惊人飞行殿庭以问于朝而复议以佛对帝遣郎中 蔡英及情景使天竺求之得佛经四十二章及释迦立像并与沙门摄摩腾竺法兰东海英之来也以白马赴经因立白马寺于洛城雍门西以处之其经兼于兰台石室而又向于清凉台即显杰林上章第十楚王英以崇敬佛法文西遇沙门佛今而智者甚众永平中法兰又一时住经其余传亦多未能通至桓帝时有安息国沙门安静经至洛翻译最为通解灵帝时有月之沙门之称天竺沙门竺佛硕等并翻佛今而之称所译泥桓经二卷学者以为大的本指汉末太守竺容易崇佛法三国时有西域沙门康僧会佛经志无意之无主孙权盛大进信未初中中国人始依佛戒 PG 795剃发为僧先是西域沙门来此一小品经首尾乖传位能通解甘露中有诸事行者往西域至于田国得经九十张晋元康中至夜一之题曰放光般若经太史中有月之沙门竺法护西游诸国大的佛经至洛翻译部数甚多佛教东流自此而盛时乐时长山沙门未到安信聪明诵经日至万余言矣胡森所译为魔法华为晋升指经思十年新了神物乃正其乖喘宣扬解释时中国纷扰四方隔绝道安乃律门图南游心也欲令玄宗所在留不分遣弟子各区诸方法信义扬州法和入蜀道安与会远之襄阳后至长安福兼胜近知道安素闻天竺沙门鸠摩罗什私通法门劝兼治之时一文安令问摇拜至敬姚长弘十二年罗时至长安时道安卒后以二十载以时生凯恨时之来也大易经论道安所证与时所译亦如一出无乖喘出境元西中新丰沙门至猛策杖西行到华士城的泥环经及僧之律东至高昌一泥环为二十卷后有天竺沙门昙摩罗谶富胡本来至河西举渠蒙逊遣使至高昌取蒙本欲相参宴为孩儿蒙逊破灭姚长弘始十年蒙本使至长安亦为三十卷昙摩罗谶又一金光明等经石胡森至长安者数十倍为鸠摩罗什才得最优其所译则为魔法华成实论等诸经及昙无谶所译金光明昙摩罗谶译泥环等经并为大乘之学而时又一时诵律天竺沙门佛陀耶舍一长阿含经及四方律都趋乐沙门昙摩难提译增译阿含经昙摩耶舍译阿毗昙论并为小臣之学其余经论不可胜计四世佛法流通及于四海矣东晋隆安中又有纪宾沙门僧迦提佛译增译阿含经集中阿含经译西中沙门之法领从于田国的华严经三万六 PG 796千纪至金陵轩亦又有沙门法显自长安游天竺经三十余国虽有经律之处学其书语义而写之还至金陵与天竺禅师拔罗参共便定为僧之律学者传之梁吉成并有外国沙门然所宣亦无大名不可为法门这梁五大重佛法于华林园中总集释释经典凡五千四百卷沙门宝唱传经目录又后为时太武帝西征长安矣 沙门多为佛律群聚会乱，乃召有司进坑沙之坟破佛像。长安僧徒一时歼灭自于真正欲闻诏书王逆的免者十一。二文臣之事又使修复西平中遣沙门会生时西域采珠。经律的170部永平中又有天竺沙门菩提留之大意。佛经与罗什相列其地持时的论并为大乘学者所。众后千叶佛法不改至周武帝时蜀郡沙门为元松上书。称僧徒伪滥武帝出诏一切废会。开皇元年高祖普照天下任听出家人令忌口出前营。造金像而金师及并周襄周洛州等诸大都邑之处并官写。一切经置于寺内而又别写藏于密阁天下之人从风而。迷境相景目民间佛经多于六经数十百倍大业时又令。沙门智果于东都内道场撰诸经目分别条贯以佛所说经为。三部一曰大乘二曰小乘三曰杂经其余四后人假托为之。者别为一部未知已经又有菩萨及诸生解奥义赞明佛理。者明之为论及戒律并有大小及中三部之别又所学者。录其实行事明之为纪凡十一种经举其大数列于此篇。又道佛经2329部7414卷。